that you will find there waiting for you. And if you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live, you can shop with us. Just go to shop.freetalklive.com. You enter the Amazon through the links you'll find there. There's different Amazons. There's Amazon UK, Amazon Canada, and Amazon US. You go into the right Amazon for you and then buy whatever you need to buy. Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale when you start your shopping at shop.freetalklive.com. As we continue with your calls and thoughts coming up, we'll talk more about the details on this survey by Gallup that has found that Americans now, for the first time in at least the last few years, have found that government is the country's biggest problem in the United States. But you know, when you dig a little deeper, things get more interesting, and Daryl's always good about digging deep into survey numbers.
Yes.
So we'll get into that. But first, your calls about whatever's on your mind. Chris, he's in Bozeman listening to KMMS. Hey, Chris.
Hey, Ian, Daryl. It's Chris Griffin, Ian, by the way.
Ah, yes. The program director of KMMS. Welcome,
yes,
sir.
Hey, I just wanted to call and say a very happy merry 2015, and thank you for all you do, you and Daryl do, with Free Talk Live for my radio station.
Thanks, Chris. It's an honor to entertain your audience. Thank you for that.
Second thing I wanted to weigh in, again, it became such an idea that sparked me. Regarding name, I didn't hear the end of your conversation because I was walking in from the garage into the home with an armful of groceries, but the importance of a name, and I don't know how you resolved that conversation with the caller, but think about it. It is so ingrained in our society that biblically, God gave Adam the right to name the animals, so names are important. And what is the first thing the priest does in an exorcism? He finds the name of the demon.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I don't know exactly what all that means, but names are important is the point I wanted to make. And as to what I think is the most important issue in America today, I think it's the misunderstanding between people. I think if I say something from a political perspective and you have a different political perspective, that very same language is completely misinterpreted and motivated people in action in a completely different manner. So misinterpretation and misunderstanding.
If you don't start on the same, in whatever conversation you're having, if you don't have the same definitions for the words that are coming out of your mouth, you might as well just be talking to a wall.
Right, and it's really bad when you have libertarians arguing with other libertarians, because sometimes it does seem like people are speaking two different languages because people have their own definitions for things.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Well, gentlemen, I appreciate, again, you continue that and do whatever you want with that. I have my own radio show in the morning, so I won't take any more of your time from other listeners. But again, thank you for all you do. And I look forward to seeing what the libertarians are going to do in a presidential election. They are ripe to step in and fill the void between what are perceived as the same party under two different names. But libertarians can make a difference if they step up and do it right.
Now, the problem is they're up against major ballot access restrictions all around the country. I don't know how difficult it is in Montana, but in some places it's not quite impossible, but darn close. And they, you know, of course, the Republicans and the Democrats, there are some things they agree on. And one of the things they agree on wholeheartedly is keeping anyone else out, whether it be the Libertarians or the Greens or whoever. Don't let anyone else into the party into the game, if you will, because that will dilute the message. It'll make it so that people actually have a choice for the first time ever, and they can't allow that. So, but I agree with you. I mean, it'd be great if the Libertarians could really step up with a good candidate. Unfortunately, the last 8 years of Libertarian candidates have been, well, let's just say they've left something to be desired.
Yeah.
So we'll keep in touch, Chris, and thank you for your call tonight. I appreciate it, man.
Take care, gentlemen.
Yep. That's Chris. He's the, I think he's the morning show host over there at KMMS in Bozeman. He is definitely a host of the station and program director, and thanks for putting us on the air. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. So what do you think, Daryl Perry? I mean, you've been following the Libertarian Party. Do you think they're going to get it together in 2016, or are they going to drop the ball and pick a half-ass Libertarian again?
Most likely they're going to go with Gary Johnson again. It seems as though he's priming up to throw his hat in the ring again.
Mm.
And
he did get more votes than anyone since 1980, right? Or no, he did better than the 1980 Libertarian guy, didn't he?
He got more overall votes,
more
but
votes.
Not a higher percentage of the vote.
Okay, so still 1980 as far as percentage.
As far as percentage, 1980 was the top. But one thing that was really bad about Gary Johnson's campaign is he was trying to get the 5% that the FEC has set of, if you get 5%, then you get
contribution?
You get federal monies as matching. And in order to get the monies, your campaign must run a deficit. So he ran a very, let's just say, a less than responsible fiscal campaign.
So is he still in debt from?
As far as I know, he's still in debt.
Wow.
So, you know, he will probably run again so that he can raise more money, basically to pay off the 2012 campaign.
You know, that's one of the things that that I hearken back to old Harry Brown from the year 1996 and 2000. I remember when he was asked if he would take the matching money, he said no.
Right. And something else that...
And I don't think he had campaign debt when it was all said and done with, or at least not
that's
a,
correct.
Not a
he
significant
did not.
Amount of any.
Something else about the Gary Johnson campaign is he waters down the libertarian message and tries to convince people that they're libertarians if they agree on one issue. Mm-hmm. So basically, his platform was everybody except for Mitt Romney and Barack Obama is a libertarian. And that's simply not true.
Well, you know, I could appreciate the idea of trying to show people where they're libertarian, and I think that to some extent he was doing that. But on the other hand, Gary Johnson isn't really a libertarian,
right,
at least in my understanding of his belief system. I mean, and when I say really a libertarian, this is sort of the old libertarian purity test, which actually used to be what you had to sign, and I think you still do, to become a member of the Libertarian Party.
There's still what they call the Libertarian Party Pledge,
which says that I don't support or advocate the initiation of force to achieve political or social goals,
right,
correct? I mean, I still remember that thing, and I signed it over a decade and a half ago, I think, at this point. I have since withdrawn my membership from the Libertarian Party nationally. Since 2008, I have not been a national Libertarian Party member. I was a life member, so I actually had to call them to cancel, to withdraw my life membership from the party. And that was actually before they chose Bob Barr as their presidential candidate. So I was really happy that I withdrew my membership because it was such an embarrassment. I would say Gary Johnson's a step up from Bob Barr.
Yes.
I would say he's a significant step up from Bob Barr. And if anything, he may have become more libertarian. It would be interesting to kind of get a feel for Gary Johnson maybe in 2010 versus, you know, 2014.
He's definitely more libertarian than he was when he was governor of New Mexico back in the 90s.
Right, because if he were more libertarian then, he could have pardoned all the nonviolent drug offenders with one.
Well, he could have but he didn't.
That's what I'm saying. So he wasn't back then, even though he's touted as this libertarian-esque governor.
He vetoed more bills. Okay, yeah, that's great, but the budget for the state of New Mexico still increased.
Yeah.
You know, they were still locking up people for nonviolent drug crimes.
And, you know, Gary Johnson, I've met him. He's been one of the few. We hardly ever have politicians on the show because I find them despicable. But we did actually have Gary Johnson in here because he was in Keene. And so, you know, or somebody brought him to Keene or whatever. So, all right, Gary Johnson's here. We'll bring him in. He was very nice. I mean, I've got nothing against the man as a
What was
as a
this
person.
When he was still running as a Republican?
No. This was as a Libertarian.
Okay.
I believe.
Because remember, he was in some of the Republican primaries.
Right. He was even in a debate, too, with Ron Paul. Right?
Yes. And then after he realized that he was going to lose and lose badly, that's when he left the Republican Party and became a Libertarian and was then handed the party on a silver platter.
We'll come back with more here in moments. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, but there still are principled people within the Libertarian Party, and I imagine they're going to try to field somebody against Johnson. We'll keep you in the loop as we learn more. It's Free Talk Live.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Hey everyone, I'm having lots of fun with my new Ghost 80% AR-15. This baby shoots like a dream. Hey, thanks Guns80.com. You know, friends ask me all the time why I wanted a Ghost AR-15. That's easy. You see, my buddy Mark kept telling me that I'd better go to Guns80.com to get myself a Ghost AR-15 before they outlawed them. I thought he was just paranoid, so I ignored it. Well, at first. But then I started hearing government and media types talking about making guns illegal, about the president signing on to a UN treaty that could take my gun rights away. You know, it really bugged me, so I dug in, I did the research, and I realized that Mark was right all along. I know now that having an unregistered Ghost AR-15 is the right answer. I'm a proud 80% Ghost AR-15 convert, you should be too. The answer is really simple. Get your Ghost AR-15 at Guns80.com. The big sale is on right now. Go to Guns80.com. That's Guns80.com. Guns80. The number's 80.com.
Because we are smothering in spam, please do not reply to all when you can instead reply. I was recently among over 100 invited to a corporate reunion. It's always a warm affair, and that's the problem. Enthusiasm for our upcoming get-together caused many recipients to RSVP the organizer with a cheery reply to all. I can't wait. Then others piled on with a reply to all to that. Then the I'm out of my office now autoresponders joined in. So I replied to all, asking that we all reply only to the organizer. Hey, at least I tried. One invitee, apparently retired, shot back, point taken, but I really like seeing the responses since they're so positive. Smiley face. This better be an open bar. From SurvivalSpeech.com, I'm Holland Cook.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything. We're here on the live Saturday edition of the program. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Here in studio, you've got me, Ian.
And Daryl.
And Daryl, courtesy of his website, fpp.cc and fppradio.com.
Yes.
Fpp.cc is more of your kind of text site with articles and, you know, original editorials and things like
yes.
that.
Yes, and books. There are
right.
books for sale.
For
and
Bitcoin.
I just redid the Bitcoin shop so that it's a little more user-friendly.
Okay.
So that, you know, you can purchase more than one of something. You can, you know, add several things in. And there's even a bulk discount. So if you want to buy several copies of a book, then you wind up saving 30% if you buy 10 or more.
So you can go there to fpp.cc to get more of Daryl, and then more in audio form at fppradio.com. You've got a thrice weekly show called Peace, Love, Liberty Radio.
Yes.
You've got a daily show, a 5-minute long newscast show, FPP Radio News.
Yes.
And that's 7 days a week.
7 days a week.
It is free over at fppradio.com.
Yes.
I think that's, to me, that's my favorite product of yours, because there's not many other people doing that out there. There's the folks at the Liberty Beat who are doing it, and they're doing a darn good job. They, I think, are still only doing 5 days a week.
5 days a week.
So you are the only person doing 7 days a week of news from sort of a Liberty perspective. It's 5 minutes. There's nobody who can't listen to a 5-minute newscast.
Right.
So, you know, however short your drive to work is in the morning, anybody can fit a 5-minute newscast in.
Yes.
So go check that out at fppradio.com as we go to your calls and thoughts. Coming up, more on the statistics. We barely touched the surface of this earlier. The Gallup poll that in 2014 has rated, Americans have rated the government as the most important problem facing the United States.
And that's actually a combination of several answers. Because this is an open-ended question that Gallup asked.
Meaning that they did not give predetermined choices.
Right. So the question that was asked, open-ended, what do you think is the most important problem facing this country today?
Okay.
And there were a couple dozen different answers overall that received, you know, some kind of response. And some of these they've added together. So for the government one, what they added together was dissatisfaction with government, Congress, politicians, poor leadership, corruption, and abuse of power.
I'd say that's fair to group all those together.
Yes.
So what? First of all, you're welcome to tell us what you think in general, but also, do you have an answer to the question? Is government the most important problem facing the country today, or what is it, if not that? If you want to be more specific, feel free. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, and we'll get more into the study here and what the numbers say in a moment. But first, Alma is on the line listening in Tallahassee to WVFT-FM. Hi, Alma.
All right. One thing that's wrong with this country, that people rip other people off. I listen to this mechanic show every week because I know a lot about vehicles.
Okay.
And I get on there and I talk and everything. And I heard him, this is not the first time I've heard it, but this is one time I called his wife off the air, and because I was my daddy's grease monkey. And they said that you have to buy a brand new radiator to go on your vehicle if there's a problem with it. And I confronted her, and I said, no, you don't. You take it, and you have it flushed. And she says, I'm not going to fuss with you. I said, well, I'm not going to fuss with you either, but you know better than that. I don't know if she does or not.
Now, just to clarify something, is this a local talk show that's like some local car repair guy?
I'm not going to say where it's at. I listen to it over the Internet. It's within 200 to 300 miles from me. It's in Florida.
So, wait, but, you called this guy's wife off the air, or you called her out on the show?
Off the air. And I said, I would not do this on the air to you, but I'm confronting you now that you shouldn't be telling people that.
Why wouldn't you call her out? Is it just because you're feeling you're really nice? I mean, why wouldn't you call her out on the air?
Well, because you're telling people a lie. You're costing people a lot of money.
That's what I'm saying. Why wouldn't you call her out on the air about that? I mean, if
because
she's...
Because they would cut me off immediately.
Oh, okay. Well, you never know what you're dealing with when you call a talk radio program. So, and thank you, by the way,
well,
Alma,
call
for the
a lot, and I know how far to go with anything.
Well, I appreciate
I know
that.
If I go any further, I won't get back on there. And I like vehicles. I like to talk about vehicles.
I see. Well, and I totally understand where you're coming from. I thank you for the call tonight. Just a couple of talk radio calling tips here. So you don't know what you're dealing with when you're calling a talk radio station. You could be dealing with, like, here in Keene, New Hampshire, there's a local morning show that, you know, has no board operator. The morning show host is the guy who's running his own board. No one is screening his phone calls. And you can tell that that's the case because he doesn't know who's calling when he takes the calls. He just answers the phone.
In fact,
around here, they don't even ask the person's name when they get them on the line, which seems kind of impersonal.
Caller, you're on the air.
Yeah, it seems kind of impersonal, but, you know, whatever. And I think they only have, like, two lines. So there's some information you can glean just by listening to the way the show is hosted. Now, if somebody is you know, if somebody is calling for a specific caller's name, like I knew that was Alma because we've got a board operator in Minnesota who's screening our calls. So, you know, if there's a board operator screening calls, then if they find out who you are, they're not, obviously, if they want to stop you from calling in, if they know your voice, they're going to stop you right there. But on a show like the morning show I was telling you about, he can't stop you from calling in. So you can just call in. Then the only thing they can do at that point, once they got you on the air, is hit the dump button on you.
Right.
Which I don't know how many stations have those. I presume
I think most it's
of them
standard
do.
Now.
I presume most of them do, but I can tell you, we didn't have one at WYNF when Free Talk Live got started back in 2002.
Right, and things have changed in the last, you know, dozen years.
The dump machine existed in 2002, right? Like, the technology existed
right,
back then.
Right, but back then, it was pretty much, you know, only the national radio shows that had the dump buttons.
Yeah. And they certainly, you could argue they're more affordable now, but
yes.
I don't think they're that much more affordable now. So what my point is that, you know, maybe they don't have the dump machine. Maybe all the worst they could do would then be to just hit the disconnect button from your phone call. I guess my point is you don't know until you try it to
right.
find, you know, to find out what is they have to combat that. But if
and
somebody's
the local show here, I know that they've got caller ID.
Okay.
So they, if they, you know, cut somebody off and that person tries calling in again, then they, you know, they can see the number and they can then refuse to take the call.
Now, do you know that because you've sat in the studio and you've seen that device? Because I've never noticed it.
I have not seen the device, but I know somebody that he got his call dumped on a Saturday morning during the open lines show.
Okay.
And then tried calling back. They didn't take his call. He called from another phone and they took it.
Oh, okay. That's a good indicator for sure.
Yes.
So you can share your thoughts with us here. And yes, we do have a dump machine. Just to give you a heads up, the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. But on this show, we will not dump you for the content or the context of your statements. We will only dump the F-bomb, the S-bomb, and a couple of other bombs like the C-bombs and
yeah.
that sort of thing.
So
say what you want here, and please call us out. If you think that we're delivering misinformation or we're, you know, not being honest or something like that, we need to be called out, and we're happy to be, so feel free.
Alma said that she thought dishonesty was the biggest problem facing the country.
Okay.
And that comes in at around 7% for the year, and it's dishonesty, ethics, moral, religious, and family decline.
And
so if somebody says like the decline of morals or decline of ethics or just dishonesty.
What was that percentage on that?
That percentage, let me go back over.
I apologize.
Because I'm looking at two different things here. 5% for the year.
Said dishonesty was the problem.
Said dishonesty or moral decline, ethical decline,
yeah.
decline of the family. The highest throughout the year was 7% for a given month.
We're going to get deeper into these numbers here in a moment, but we're going to go to your calls first. Don is listening in Albuquerque to Kiva. Hello, Don.
Hi, welcome back to the Albuquerque market. It's good to hear you guys again.
Man, it's like program director night tonight. Now, Don, you're the former program director over at Kiva, and you actually put us on years ago there. So welcome back to the show.
Yeah, sure did. No, it's Eddie's got you guys back going, which I think is an absolutely fabulous thing, and
yeah.
I love your show.
Thank you.
So you guys were talking about Gary Johnson.
Yeah.
And I'm a fan of the man in some ways. He was by far the best governor in my lifetime here in New Mexico, although that is not a very high bar. But,
I believe you.
You know, with people like Bill Richardson in our history, which was a tragic period for the state, and he's a tragic man. The man is... he doesn't care what anybody thinks. He's in it only for himself. And it's just a remarkable thing to see the behavior of somebody like that. But Gary did a great job here in New Mexico within the framework of the context of the times. And I think that there's a case for you take the person who's better than the others, and I will tell you, Gary is a whole lot better than most.
Oh, no doubt. I will give you that. I'll give you that. If it were Gary Johnson versus George Bush and Hillary Clinton, it'd be a clear choice for me. But hang on, Don. If you had more to say, we'll bring you back here in a moment. 855-450-FREE, program director night here on Free Talk Live. More coming up. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Majid lives in Nor Deven, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, January 2nd, 2015. Gold is trading at $1,184. Silver at $16.02, and Bitcoin is trading around $315.93. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest, most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Your job, your home, your car, your money. All of these provide you with a sense of security. But what about your family security? What have you done to prepare if all of these things were gone? eFoods Direct has the food security you need for every emergency. eFoods Direct is food security. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 and mention Liberty Beat for 50% off their food preparation planning packs. In the news, on Monday, the ACLU and Human Rights Watch demanded that the U.S. Department of Justice appoint a special prosecutor to investigate the CIA's use of torture methods. In a letter to Attorney General Eric Holder, the civil rights groups said the recent Senate Intelligence Committee report on the CIA includes new information that should be properly investigated. The group stated that failure to conduct a comprehensive criminal investigation would contribute to the notion that torture is acceptable. On Wednesday, leaders of the Senate Judiciary Committee announced that they were seeking details from the Obama administration regarding federal law enforcement's use of cell phone surveillance technology. In a bipartisan letter to the Departments of Justice and Homeland Security, Senators Patrick Leahy and Chuck Grassley requested more information about a recent policy change by the FBI regarding how surveillance equipment is used. 16 Iowa farmers and companies have filed suit against Syngenta Ag for losses incurred after China rejected corn shipments containing a genetically modified seed made by the corporation. The lawsuits state that Syngenta has caused damage to U.S. farmers, grain handlers, and exporters. The farmers also call Syngenta negligent for prematurely selling the seed before it was approved by countries that are major markets for U.S. corn exports. This broadcast of the Liberty Beat is made possible by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your message or product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To find out more, visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 2nd, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. This is a Liberty Beat special report. An Austin Police Department detective is suing the city of Austin, claiming the department retaliated against her after she filed an internal affairs complaint for alleged sexual harassment and discrimination. Detective Brenda Bermudez, who has been with the department since 2001, asserts in her lawsuit that during her time with the Human Trafficking Division, male detectives would physically block her from entering the room when they were dealing with nude women during undercover operations, so as to prolong the encounter with the unclothed female. The lawsuit also says that male APD employees would show Bermudez, who is a lesbian, online pornographic images of women from prostitution websites, and then ask her if she would have sex with them. After Detective Bermudez took the allegations to internal affairs last year, she was transferred to the auto theft unit, while her male counterparts remained with the human trafficking division. Additionally, the city reprimanded Bermudez for alleged sexual harassment of her male co-workers. The lawsuit comes on the heels of a recently released dashcam video showing two Austin police officers joking about raping a woman. Police accountability activists in Austin took to social media to lay blame at the hands of Austin Police Chief Art Acevedo, whose leadership they claim has become known for being lenient on misconduct while punishing and firing officers who complain against their fellow officers. The Liberty Beat will keep you up to date as this story continues to unfold. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support also comes from The Corey Moore Show, live every Friday night at 10 o'clock Eastern at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, January 2nd, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Sources at the video streaming service Netflix reported today that they had sent local man Shane Fowler a personal message earlier just checking to see if everything was okay after the 31-year-old watched an entire season of the FX program Sons of Anarchy in a single viewing session.
Well, we happened to notice that Shane had been sitting in front of his laptop and had burned through all 13 episodes of the first season of Sons of Anarchy. So we thought maybe we could send him a note and just sort of make sure he was doing all right, or if he needed someone to talk to or something.
Netflix says the message, which Fowler received minutes after he finished viewing the season one finale of the motorcycle gang drama, was just a way for the company to see if there was anything they could do for their longtime subscriber.
I mean, we do this stuff all the time. Just last year, Mike Rawlson from Bartlesville, Oklahoma, watched all four seasons of The Tudors after his wife left him. We were there for him. We just like to check in on our customers from time to time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, you may dial toll-free in here to bring up anything you'd like. 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733. We've just scratched the surface on this Gallup study asking Americans, what do they think is the most important problem in the country today? Number one results, government. Now there's different sort of versions of that, like politicians, corruption, etc. But averaged all together, the number one answer was government. And it was not the number one answer last year or the year before that. In fact, it was number two last year, and prior to that, it was number three. So government has become less popular over time, or at least over the last few years, according to this survey.
Not only less popular, but viewed as the biggest problem.
That's correct. So we'll get into more of that here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Some of the calls in the last hour led into a discussion about the Libertarian Party and, you know, what's going to happen in 2016. Are they going to field Gary Johnson again? And we had Don, who was on the line in Albuquerque. He dropped off during the news, but actually former program director of our station there in Kiva, he was saying that, you know, Gary Johnson for sure was the best governor in his lifetime in New Mexico.
He also said that that's a very low bar to jump over.
That's true. I will give Gary Johnson credit for being markedly better than Bob Barr. Bob Barr was a low point for the Libertarian Party. They actually ran him as a presidential candidate in 2008, and it was a total embarrassment, in my opinion. And I'm glad I resigned from the Libertarian Party prior to him being approved. And I haven't really seen reason to rejoin the Libertarian Party nationally. I did join the New Hampshire Libertarian Party. But I don't think your dues are current there. Yeah, I think you're probably right about that. Yeah, nobody sent me any kind of reminder, and I certainly
they don't do that.
Yeah, I certainly didn't set a calendar event to remind me to re-up with that. So I guess I'm not a current member of the Libertarian Party. But anyway, you're welcome to share your thoughts here. Toll-free number is 855-453. We pointed out how difficult it can be for liberty-minded candidates to actually get on the ballot, so that whoever it is that gets chosen, because that's the first issue. The first hurdle to jump over is to pick the right candidate. They've bombed on that one the last few years. But if they were to actually pick a person who actually cares about the ideas of freedom and is principled and understands what they're all about, then getting that person on the ballot then becomes the real challenge.
Yes.
And that requires countless thousands of dollars, probably hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars. I don't know what it costs in total across all 50 states, because each state has different requirements.
Right. And the Libertarian Party is currently ballot qualified in, I believe, 30 states across the country, meaning that, you know, they met some arbitrary vote threshold.
So that's not as hard to get on?
In this last election. So they're automatically on in 2016 in about 30 states.
That's good.
Which means that you only have 20 states plus D.C. that you have to jump over a hurdle.
And some of them are very, very difficult, like Oklahoma is one of the worst, right?
Oklahoma, it is near impossible. It has not been done since the year 2000.
Wow.
The year 2000 is the last time something other than a Republican or a Democrat was on for president. And Oklahoma does not allow write-in votes.
Oh, man.
Yeah. So your choice literally is, you know, turd sandwich or giant douche.
So I think a lot of people don't understand. They don't understand this, Daryl. If they are familiar with the Libertarian Party, maybe they've heard of the party, or they've maybe heard of a candidate locally or nationally or something at some point in the past, and they may wonder why they just don't have a bigger impact. Well, it's because you spend so much time and effort just trying to get on the ballot. By the time you've done that, you know, your campaign chest, however small it was, is exhausted at that point. And, you know, then you've got to actually run a campaign.
And so in some states, such as Pennsylvania, and the Libertarians haven't been on in the last several years in Pennsylvania because the, you know, Republicans or Democrats, one will challenge their petitions. They then have to spend thousands of dollars, tens of thousands of dollars, to go to court to, you know, say we deserve to be on the ballot. Our signatures are valid.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, after that process goes through, well, they've wasted all of their money just trying to stay on the ballot.
Yeah. So that's what Libertarians are really dealing with, is all of the hurdles put up by the Republicans and Democrats. If they didn't have to do that, if they could just get on the ballot just by signing a form and paying a small fee or something like that, then, you know, maybe things would be a little more fair. But then even once you get on the ballot, then you have the difficulty of actually running a campaign, which on its own is challenging, but especially so when you have rules like debates where it's near impossible to actually get your candidate into a debate. So even if you've gone through the process and you've gotten your candidate on the ballot, then you've got these debate commissions that have basically set the rules to where, oh, well, you could be in the debate so long as you're polling at 10% or 12% or 20% or something like that.
15% national average of five polls.
Yeah.
So one thing, and I you know, have to applaud Gary Johnson on this. One thing that he did was he commissioned polls asking if the election were held today and the candidates were Mitt Romney or Gary Johnson, who would you vote for? And of course he got over 15%. He also commissioned polls that said if the candidates were Barack Obama and Gary Johnson. And he got over 15%. There were at least five of these done.
That's pretty smart.
He presented those to the Commission on Presidential Debates, and they ignored them.
Off. Yep.
So he does have a lawsuit against the Commission on Presidential Debates.
Oh, interesting.
So I applaud him on that.
All right, all right. Well, yeah, I mean, like I said, he's not a terrible candidate.
Right. He's just not a great libertarian.
Let's continue here. We've got Sheila. She's in Los Angeles. You're on Free Talk Live. Hey, Sheila.
Hey. If it's not too far off topic, I actually have a question. I'm a fairly new listener, and I understand that that you and your co-host there, I think it's Daryl, are not too enamored with Stefan Molyneux, and I've listened to quite a number of his videos. I enjoyed them and gotten a lot out of them, so I was just curious what happened to cause his fall from favor or put him in the doghouse with you guys, if you wouldn't mind answering that.
I don't know what Daryl's viewpoint is, so I'm interested in hearing Daryl about
Stefan Molyneux. I've never been a fan.
Who is he?
Stefan Molyneux is a Canadian podcaster that fancies himself a philosopher. I really don't know a lot more about him. I don't listen to his podcast, mainly because they're all extremely long. And, you know, I don't listen to a lot of really long podcasts. Every now and then I'll listen to an hour-long podcast that's done by a friend of mine if it's on a topic that interests me.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, you know, if it's something, you know, longer than 10 minutes, yeah, I'm not really going to listen. So, you know, I've never been a fan. I've heard some of the things recently about, like, a fraudulent IP claim. I know that he got upset a couple of years ago about somebody giving him a $2 donation. But other than that, I don't really know a lot about him, and okay, so, I've just never been a fan.
Yeah, so I've never had a problem with Stefan up until recently. He and I have gotten along in person just fine, and he's actually been a co-host of Free Talk Live as a guest from, like, the Porcupine Freedom Festival in the past. But I started to notice, like, I started to get kind of a weird feeling from him when he started releasing a series of videos called The Truth About... And then there would be some name or something, you know, the truth about Nelson Mandela, the truth about whoever. And I just kind of feel weird when someone's out there touting that they have the truth, because it seems kind of know-it-all, like this a bit of hubris, if you will, like, I have the truth. Listen to me and you will know the truth. And it just seemed weird to me, and I didn't like the way that felt. Then later, I didn't pull him off the air for that. I didn't pull him off the air for the $2 thing, which I'd also heard about, where he turned his nose up at a small donation that
the post on Facebook was, don't mean to sound disappointed, but frowny face.
Yeah. And so those were disturbing to me, but then when I finally heard some of the comments that had a misogynistic tone to them, which were outlined on the True Shibes YouTube channel that he had ostensibly made on his podcast, that was when I was kind of like, okay, this has gone far enough, and I just am not interested in having his show on the network that I program, which is LRN.FM, which is an internet-based radio network. And then it was shortly after I pulled him off the air that the situation happened where he and his manager used copyright law to take down a critical YouTube channel and were not apologetic for it at all when confronted on it, which that to me would have also been the last straw had it needed to be, but it wasn't. So Sheila, I hope that answered your question. I thank you for the call tonight. There's more coming up here on Free Talk Live. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. The Constitution was not America's first governing document. The first was the Articles of Confederation, created in 1775, under which the existing states grouped themselves as a union. Under the Articles, votes by the 13 states had to be unanimous, and what was enacted didn't have the force of law. It was merely a suggestion to the state. The Constitution's supporters, the Federalists, argued that the Articles were weak because the nation couldn't make good on its debts or prevent squabbles among states. Be careful what you wish for, their opponents, the Anti-Federalists, warned. A more powerful federal government could dominate the states and people. The Anti-Federalists lost that battle and the new Constitution was ratified. But it is in large part thanks to them that we have a Bill of Rights, the first 10 amendments to the Constitution adopted to address their concerns. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Free Talk Live.
It's written in legalese. If you don't have training in reading that crap, it might as well be a foreign language. Mm. And as you pointed out, it doesn't matter if you can read it.
I thought I had them dead to rights. And these bureaucrats, they just like, no, we do whatever we want here at the zoning board.
Yeah, that's right.
And you'll kiss our butts.
Peon. Serf.
You'll
slave.
You'll do what we say.
Yeah. Why label them citizens?
Well,
why not just call it what it is? You're a serf. You're a slave. Well, we're the freest slaves in the world. If you don't like this slavery, you should go to some other country and be a slave. At least we got cell phones and TV and beer.
Do have beer.
Our masters let us live a pretty nice life. They let us keep 40% of what we earn.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You may take control toll-free here. 855-450-FREE. What is the number one problem facing the United States? Americans say it's government. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's a Gallup poll. We'll get more into that here in a moment. Daryl has been busily dissecting it. But I want to let you know, if you care about online privacy, you need to know about ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network, and they encrypt your online data, which means that your internet service provider or maybe the coffee shop administrator that you're sitting at right now, they won't know what you're doing online anymore. Right now, they could be logging all the websites you visit. The search terms that you enter could be keeping those logs, in some cases, up to 5 years. You can put a stop to that by going to proxpn.com/FTL. The software is free. Just download it for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, as well as Android devices. Linux users, setup's a little different for you, but you can get ProXPN working with Linux as well. So go to proxpn.com/FTL to get started. And when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account to get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, the ability to privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites, just use code FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live. And the number 50 as in 50% off, which, by the way, that discount is good for the lifetime of the account. So once your first year is done, you still get the 50% off for year number two. So go to proxpn.com/FTL to get the discount. Use FTL50 as your code. And you get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Again, that's proxpn.com/FTL. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Let's go to your calls and thoughts. Michael is in Virginia Beach listening to WNIS. Hello, Michael.
Hello, and yes, the Gallup polls. I just want to caution you that in 1980, Gallup, the night before the presidential election in November of 1980, predicted that the race was too close to call. And what we learned the day after was that Reagan won by a landslide. Then Mr. Gallup began appearing on the 700 Club to try to explain why they got it so wrong. Not just he or his polling agency, but all the other agencies. And the reason he came up with is they did not factor in the evangelical conservative Protestant vote, or that factor, which means that they had not factored in the power of the religious broadcasters who decided to make Ronald Reagan their candidate. So presumably now, this realigned, re-educated Gallup poll has figured out how to take the measure of the full population to understand what our greatest problem is.
Well, they don't measure the full population. They only measure 1,000 people typically, right? It's 1,000 is the typical
right, and that's poll. You know, there have been studies that have shown that 1,000 will give you about a plus or minus 3% of what the, you know, the total population would wind up thinking. And that, is with like a 95% accuracy. So when you look at something and the plus or minus 3%, that winds up going, it gives you basically a 6-point swing. So if 18% of the people say something, it could be as low as 15 or as high as 21.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, we know all that. But basically, there's a consensus that says this is quite accurate reading. Well, we the people are the government.
No, so you're not. Would you cut it out? No, you're not the government unless you actually are. Are you getting a paycheck from the state?
If the government is a problem, it is those same people who in previous elections were not counted because they weren't involved, because their preachers didn't tell them to get involved, just like their preachers didn't tell them to care about civil rights. It wasn't until Martin Luther King came along, stirred the conscience of the nation so that church leaders finally decided, well, we're going to talk about civil rights. Then they decided they would get involved. Now we hear from the Wall Street Journal today, a front page story about churches being sold in Europe. Taking Netherlands, for example, they have 1,600 Catholic churches. They expect in the next decade that two-thirds of those churches will be closed.
What's the point? What are you driving at here? Are you suggesting that that churches closing is going to result in less political participation?
What I'm saying is that the conscience of the people is either stirred or deadened by their political leaders in Europe, by their religious leaders. In Europe, the people have said, we don't need you, we don't want you, they're not going to church anymore. In America, they haven't quite come to that point yet, but they are still responsible for the lack of doing just what you're doing on this show, telling us we need to talk about jury nullification.
So what you're saying is you're saying that you blame churches for not activating their parishioners?
Absolutely.
Thanks for the call tonight, Michael. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What do you think about that, Daryl?
I don't know. There's definitely an argument to be made, but I don't know if I necessarily agree with the argument.
At first, it sounded like he was calling into question the Gallup Pulse polling company.
Right, that's what I thought he was questioning as well.
And, as far as what he was saying about the Reagan election, I'm not intimately familiar with what happened there, so I'm just going to take him at his word. That is that the polls were drastically different you know, the day before the election versus the election.
Right. And something else as far as that, when they do these polls, they just show the national breakdown.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the pollsters do not wind up going further and determining which states somebody's going to win or lose. Mm. Now, they've started doing that a little bit now, and so they'll come up like, these are the 10 swing states. But they don't necessarily wind up, you know, factoring in the Electoral College when they tell you, you know, it's too close to call.
I mean, 1,000 people is not perfect, right? Like,
right.
That's a very small sample compared to 300 million.
Even if you called all 300 million people
mm-hmm.
on, you know, October 7th, and the election is, you know, about a month away.
Yeah.
If you were able to speak to all 300 million people and made your prediction based off of what those 300 million people told you, you still would not be accurate because you have to take into consideration the large percentage of people that will not vote.
Correct.
The percentage of people that will change their vote based on what the polls tell them.
They're undecided until the election.
Because some people, they want to make sure that they're on the winning side, so they'll vote with the person that they're told is in the lead.
Yeah.
Well, so, you know, there's no way to accurately predict the outcome of an election until you see the election results.
Yeah, a poll is nothing more than a curiosity. It's just something to occupy time on a, you know, a television news feed, essentially. They're not useful in predicting the future.
Right.
They're interesting. They're curious, but that's about it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You are welcome to share your thoughts here. But nonetheless, you know, polls like this one that are happening over time, those are more useful.
Right, and they've been doing this for like 50 years.
Right. The question being, what's the most important problem in the country today in the United States? The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. If you'd like to share your thoughts, this is Free Talk Live.
Alex Jones here. For the last 2 years, I've been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to design a nutraceutical formulation that has truly life-changing health benefits. So many other formulations out there contain toxic ingredients, synthetic additives, and even GMOs. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure ancient defense for you and your family. Visit InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you to go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you
are? Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this hospital.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't gonna make it.
Wait a minute.
Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running?
Because you're scared of me.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308.
It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
This is a national health care alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. So if you're on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. We also have other pain-relieving braces, too, for your shoulder, ankle, or back. You may be eligible to get these items and more at little or no out-of-pocket cost. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to help you, so please call now. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free to bring up whatever you'd like. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we have waiting for you on the site. Those other talk show hosts, many of them will charge you for their websites. Ours is free, so enjoy at freetalklive.com. You can also enjoy Daryl's websites, fpp.cc and fppradio.com, as we go back to the phones and the fun. Coming up, we'll tell you more about the Gallup poll that has found that Americans now number one concern, the most important problem in the country, according to Americans, is the government. Let's go first, though, to your calls and thoughts. We've got Mac calling from Saudi Arabia. You're on Free Talk Live. Mac.
Hey, how you doing, fellas?
Welcome, sir.
I wanted to call because I'm a little bit older than you guys. I'm maybe 15 years older than you. And I remember the propaganda about marijuana the drug crusaders were promulgating back in the early and mid-70s. And, you know, it was you still had remnants of the belief or the propaganda that, you know, if you smoke one marijuana cigarette, you'll go insane for the rest of your life. And, you know, the drug craze. What was that movie called that they made back in the 30s?
Reefer Madness.
There you go, Reefer Madness. And now I work out here in Saudi Arabia, and you can't bring drugs or alcohol into the country. They'll literally kill you for it. It's
right.
a death penalty for those kinds of things.
So there must be no drugs in Saudi Arabia whatsoever.
I just got finished talking to a guy out here, actually, who said that cannabis smoking is really big among the youth around here in Saudi Arabia. But, yeah, that's not very
surprising. Just to clarify something, I'm just curious. Is it that if you get caught bringing it into the country, it's a death penalty, but if you're just on the streets with it, it's not? What's the deal there?
Well, I don't know about pot per se, but I know a guy, there was a guy out here that tried to bring some tequila. He put green food coloring in it and tried to hide it in a scope bottle, you know, the mouthwash scope. Mm-hmm. And they caught him at the border when he tried to get in, and they arrested him, but the company bailed him out. We worked for Saudi Aramco. That's the contractor. I actually contract from a company that contracts from Saudi Aramco. Saudi Aramco runs this country, so if they said let him go, well, they're going to let him go.
If somebody was just caught with it on the streets. You just know that if it were brought in, then that's a problem?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that it's the death penalty if you have it here in the country. But if they stop you at the border, they didn't kill this guy. So obviously,
teenagers in Saudi Arabia, they don't care about death. They're willing to, they want to get high so bad that they're willing to risk death by firing squad or hanging or whatever the hell they do to you in Saudi Arabia. in order to get high.
Yeah, hanging or whatever.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, exactly. That's pretty much it. Yeah. But I know that you know a lot about drugs, Ian, and I don't know if you've ever messed with methamphetamine or not. I never have.
No, I have no interest in that.
Well, we have a guy that it's not when I worked here, it's when I worked in a different country, Kuwait. We had a guy who, he was a meth head. I mean, he would tell you that he was a meth head when he was on his days off. So he worked on a 28 and 28 schedule. He was here, he was in Kuwait for 28 days and at home for 28 days. Now, the entire 28 days he was at home, he was doing meth, I guess every day, I don't know.
Oh, my.
And he would show up and he would have kind of scabs on his face where, I guess, guys that are on meth, they tend to pick at their face. I think that's a habit that the meth users have.
They pick at their whole bodies, from what I understand. Yeah.
Yeah, and so as when he arrived into the country, as the weeks progressed, his face would clear up, his eyes wouldn't look so sunken. He didn't look quite until he would start. But he would go home and he would get right back on the meth. Now the government propaganda is that this meth stuff is deadly. It'll kill you. It's nothing to mess with. You know, we've all seen the pictures, the before and after pictures. And I just wonder, and I'm not an apologist for drug use, certainly not methamphetamines. However, I wonder if the propaganda about meth is the same idea as the propaganda that I heard as a child back, about marijuana. In other words, what I'm trying to say is, meth really as bad as the government says it is, as the drug warriors say?
So probably.
That's my question to you, Ian.
Yeah. Okay. So as somebody who, the only experience I have with methamphetamine is having known people who've used methamphetamine
and watching Breaking Bad.
I would say there's some accuracy to Breaking Bad, but. So, with the limited knowledge that I have about it, I would say that generally the government is not to be trusted on anything that they say. So it's probably not as bad as they make it out to be, but it's still pretty bad. Like, methamphetamine's a pretty serious drug addiction to have. And yes, the consequences are pretty horrible to witness, especially when you're witnessing it happen to somebody that you care about. As you've seen, this coworker of yours did not look good. And that's, it's a very powerful, addictive drug. Of course, as some have pointed out, people get drug addictions because of the circumstances in their life and them not wanting to really deal with those circumstances. I remember the study we talked about here on the air, which was fascinating, was where they took meth addicts and crack addicts, two of the arguably most, addictive drugs out there. And they put them in a hospital environment, and they gave them the access to their drug of choice, to either meth or crack. And they were giving them access to, like, hospital quality, like good, like, no doubt.
Pure.
This was the best crack they'll ever smoke or the best meth they'll ever use. And what they did at the same time was they told these addicts, well, good morning. They were there for a few weeks. Good morning. You have access now to a big hit of crack. Or we will give you $20 at the end of the 3 weeks. What's your choice? And what they found out was that these people would choose the $20 because they, even though the short-term benefits of being able to smoke the meth would have been very, very desirable, they could still see the long-term benefits of, waiting and being patient and collecting the cash at the end. So it wasn't like they were getting the cash that day with which they could go then buy some crack with. They had to wait till they were done with the three-week long trial period. And what they determined was that the people who were in this situation, normally they wouldn't behave that way in their regular life because there was nothing to live for. There was no $20 at the end of the rainbow. There was just another day of hell in the ghetto or wherever it was that they lived. And so they were using it to get away. They had nothing to look forward to in their lives. So I think it just all depends. I knew a lady who was using methamphetamine basically as speed, and she was using it to clean her house or whatever. And I think that she, She didn't lose control. So maybe it's possible, I don't know how likely it is, to use these drugs without losing yourself in them completely to addiction. We had one guy call this show a couple of years ago saying that he was a weekend warrior heroin user, that he wasn't using heroin on a daily basis, that he would only use it on the weekends, and he swore to us that he was a responsible heroin user. So usually you don't hear stories about those people. I would imagine the reason you don't hear those stories is because if you're able to responsibly use heroin or methamphetamine, then you don't make any headlines because, you know, you don't end up dead because of it. At least that's the theory.
And it could be argued that some of these things, like, you know, the crystal meth, would probably not really exist if it were not for the drug war.
That's true as well.
Because crystal meth, you know, it's over-the-counter things that you mix together and you can make this in your house.
So the short answer would be, yeah, they're probably not, you know, telling the full truth because they're the government. But on the other hand, I don't want that statement to make it sound like I'm endorsing either of those two drugs. They are two of the most serious and dangerous and, you know, deadly kind of drugs out there. I mean, the meth can cause all kinds of crazy hallucinations, which, if you did watch Breaking Bad, are sort of given some screen time there. So I hope that helped, Mac. Appreciate the call tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I'm not opposed to recreational drug use, but I am in favor of people knowing what the hell they're getting into. So I recommend that you go to Erowid.org, E-R-O-W-I-D.org. It's a great website that you can visit to learn all kinds of information about various drugs, prescription and non-prescription.
Times are different than they were when GEICO started saving people money over 75 years ago. Everybody takes photos of their food nowadays. You can bet none of us kids would snap pictures of Mom's tuna casserole surprise. To this day, we don't know what the surprise was, nor do we want to. We didn't always have tasty food, but we always had great car insurance with GEICO.
GEICO, saving people money on car insurance for over 75 years.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
The knowledge of the ancients. Tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure Ancient Defense for you and your family. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. That's AncientDefense.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another micro-loan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You dial toll-free here to bring up anything you'd like. The live Saturday edition continues. We'll take your calls about anything. 855-450-FREE. Plus, coming up, more on the Gallup survey that found that Americans say that government is the country's biggest problem. What do you think is the most important problem in the United States right now, or wherever it is you happen to be in the world? You can still answer that question. Usually, I think the answer will be government from many people, regardless of which country we're talking about, because, well, those government guys are kind of thugs wherever it is you go around the world. Our toll-free number again is 855-450-FREE. You can join us online. Go to freetalklive.com to interact there. And if you like the show and you appreciate what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, something you can do to help us out a whole lot is to become a Free Talk Live amplifier. The AMP program stands for Advertise, Market, and Promote, and the idea is to get Free Talk Live into more ears around the world via radio stations, getting on more stations. We've got over 150 stations, which is great, but we can have 300, 400, 500. That's all possible. Just needs, you know, more money to market the show. And some of that money goes to pay you, Daryl, for doing affiliate relations for Free Talk Live. Some of it goes to sending the host of the show to yearly conventions to schmooze it up with the talk radio bigwigs. Some of it goes to advertising Free Talk Live to talk radio stations, sort of in the industry publications that exist. And those are some of the things that we can do with $5 a month from you. And you get perks. You get access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only forum, the AMP-only Facebook group, which is very popular, and you get it all for $5 a month at least. If you want to do more, you can do that too. Go to amp.freetalklive.com. That's A-M-P, amp.freetalklive.com.
And if somebody sends you a one-time $2 donation, you will not post about it with a frowny face on Facebook.
I would be happy to receive a $2 donation one time. Thank you in advance for doing that. If that's all you got, if you got $2, that's all you can send our way, thank you. I appreciate it because it all adds up. It makes a difference. Let's go to, if we could get $2 from every listener, we'd never have to ask for money again, if that were the case.
Yeah.
You know, we only have like a few hundred amplifiers, and I know that we have probably a few hundred thousand listeners. So,
right.
Gosh, if I could get a dollar or two from every listener, that we wouldn't have to run advertising on the show, if that were the case. Anyway, let's continue with your calls and thoughts. We will go to Robert, listening in Panama City. You're on Free Talk Live, Robert.
Hey, thank you for taking my call.
Welcome,
and I'm not here to throw necessarily lawyers under the bus, but if you look at the amount of litigation at the work that's being done by attorneys on a routine basis in this country to twist and turn the law around one way or the other, I think that's one of the biggest problems we face, because ultimately a lot of those turn into judges.
Mm.
They also turn into politicians.
Yeah, I think you're absolutely right.
I don't know how we could find a way to restrict the number of attorneys in this country, but I do know one of my children has a cartoon. And in the cartoon, they say, well, we don't have attorneys. It's one of these futuristic kind of cartoons. And the question was, well, why don't you have attorneys? And it says, well, because we give them the same penalty as the people they represent. In other words, they face the same ultimate, and think about this.
We should do that for the prosecutors, though. Like, if the prosecutor loses a case, that they should take the penalty.
Ooh, interesting. Yeah.
So wait a minute, but Robert. I think that's an interesting point because if you want to break it down, people are saying here in the Gallup survey that government's the problem, but lawyers are one of the biggest problems with government. Given that if you look at, as you pointed out, the politicians and the breakdown, almost all of them are lawyers. I mean, and so what they're doing is the politicians, lawyers mostly, are writing new laws that their buddies in law who are still practicing can then use to make more money off of you and I. So the whole system is really sort of by lawyers for lawyers.
Well, let me take exception to some of your words there, because that's exactly the reason why I took my time tonight away from myself just to call.
You mentioned
earlier about how worthless and horrible politicians are. I was a politician I was in office for 4 years. I made a lot of people in my community mad, people of wealth, people of means, people that sway things around so they can make some money. They're not Republicans or Democrats. They're statists.
Oh, sure.
All they want is the government to make them money. And the more people that are, they don't get a taste for politics because they're afraid of people condemning them for being politicians. So, yeah, there's plenty of politicians out there that need to have their butts kicked. But there's also people out there who have taken time from their lives to serve their communities, to serve their areas that they represent.
Yeah, I think that's true. And
they're decent people. And, you know, when we get into this, throw everybody under the bus, I can tell you, there's some attorneys that I love.
No doubt.
They're respectable people.
They are good people.
Well, but you know what? When I hear somebody who's an attorney say, well, I can argue both sides of the case, I turn a deaf ear to that person because they don't believe in anything.
Mm.
And that's the problem with this country today is we don't believe in anything.
I have to disagree with you because and here's why. When I was in high school, I was on the debate team, and we were taught to be able to argue both sides of any topic. And while, yes, I have my beliefs on topics, I can still look at things from both sides. So to say that you automatically dismiss somebody that says that they can understand or argue both sides of a topic, that they don't believe or stand for anything, then that's a blatant misrepresentation.
Well, I was number two in the state of Florida in 1974 in debate. A guy named Sam and I were partners, and we won the second place in the state of Florida. So maybe you won first place that year.
Well, no, I get where I think I get where you're both coming from, though. Like, what I understand where you're both coming from. Like, I wouldn't want to work with an attorney who is like, well, I'll take either side. Just pay me.
Right.
I think that's kind of what you're saying.
The government employs the most of is attorneys.
Yeah.
And attorneys in government can argue both sides. They don't care because they're going to make money either way.
That's true.
They have nothing to lose whatsoever. And what I witness is that in public finance, for instance, when they get into doing bonds, and you hear the word bonds, oh, we're going to do a bond issue, we're going to do a bond issue. Nobody even thinks about that, but it's like a mortgage. And we're borrowing money to do this water project or this road or this building or something like that. The attorney is over there pushing that train. Because why? Because they get a percentage of that deal. And the architects that are designing it, they get a percentage of that deal. And all these people line up in the feed trough.
Oh, yeah.
And they're feeding off government. And why? Because some attorneys convince some politician that this is the right thing to do.
So I've got a solution, Robert. It's not a perfect one, but it's one that seems to work fairly well, at least here in New Hampshire. And I'm originally from Florida. I know how bad things are down there. At least I knew how bad they were a decade ago since I've been there. But in New Hampshire, the state representatives get paid $100 a year in salary. Now, there's a per diem travel fee.
A travel expense. It's not technically a per diem.
It's a
travel reimbursement.
Okay.
That averages out to about $2,700 per state rep.
Right. So when you look at the numbers, the total numbers, New Hampshire is the lowest. They do not pay very much at all. And the fact is, an attorney, they're used to getting paid $300 an hour or thereabouts. And so it will be very unattractive for an attorney to take a position in a legislature that only pays $100 a year plus travel expenses. And in New Hampshire, we also have 400 state representatives. So the amount of power that each one of them has is fairly diluted compared, they may be diluted, but their power is diluted. Anyway, they, you know, they just don't have as much power as they would if they were a Florida state legislature or legislator, and they don't get paid as much. So I think that keeps them more honest. It makes it more or less likely that power seekers would be the kind of folks who would take those offices.
And there's a difference between a politician and an elected official.
Is there?
I would say that
there is. Is a politician only the person running for office?
No, I would say that, you know, a politician is someone that is never going to give you a straight answer about something. Whereas, you know, there definitely are people that run for office and do wind up getting elected, and they honestly want to do what they believe is best for the community, and they'll actually answer a question straightforward and not beat around the bush.
Okay.
So I would say that there's a difference between a politician and an elected official.
Robert, I want to thank you for the call tonight.
Somebody goes and twists those words against you when you do it.
Thanks for the call tonight, man.
I can tell you from experience.
I do appreciate it, and I believe you, and I appreciate the experience as well. Thank you for it. Let's go to Nathan. He's listening to WIBC in Indianapolis. Hello, Nathan.
Hey.
Welcome, sir.
I was just listening. I haven't heard the show before, so I'm not sure what the format is, but I turned
open
it over and you're talking about
every night.
Okay, yeah, I mean, Libertarians was mentioned earlier.
Yes, sir.
And I've thought a lot over the years about, you know, the third parties and such. And I know the Tea Party came along and kind of flowed right in with the Republicans to some extent. I know they are some third party races, but they didn't try and compete with the major parties that everybody kind of has embedded in. It's either this or that. And it kind of, you know, scares me sometimes to try and pay much attention or vote for the third one, because it's going to just waste my vote. How many people it's going
to... I want to talk to you further about that. Hang on, the whole wasted vote idea. If you don't mind, stand by, Nathan. We'll bring you back here after the news in moments. 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number. This is Free Talk Live.
Hi, everyone. I'm Chuck Woolery. After putting a few thousand couples together on Love Connection, you know that nothing kills romance faster than bad breath. Smart Mouth gets at the cause of bad breath without the burn. And you get clean breath for about 12 hours. Other mouthwashes only prevent bad breath for about an hour. Gum and mints, well, they just cover it up. Use Smart Mouth in the morning for great breath all day. Rinse in the evening for clean, kissable breath all night. You can even wake up without morning breath. Smart Mouth, for 12 hours of real clean breath, look for the green box at your favorite store.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free speech is protected on the internet, right? Not always. Government agencies try to limit free speech and commerce on the net. Luckily, when they do, the Institute for Justice is there to defend your First Amendment right to free speech. IJ helped set the first federal precedent for internet free speech in 1999, and ever since has worked to prevent unconstitutional roadblocks in cyberspace. Visit our website today at ij.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Earl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, January 3rd, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.78 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,189 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $301. Antiwar.com reports the State Department has warned it intends to review all aid provided to the Palestinian Authority in the wake of their bid to join the International Criminal Court, saying the bid would have implications. Congress has already mandated that all aid to the Palestinians be cut off if they attempt to file a single claim against the Israeli occupation, though clearly the U.S. often ignores its own law with respect to aid provisions at any rate. The U.S. has made it clear they oppose ICC membership for the Palestinians, though there does not seem to be any particular reason for the ICC to deny their membership. The Palestinian Authority decided to pursue the bid after their failed attempt to pass a resolution calling for an end to the Israeli occupation at the UN Security Council, which the U.S. vetoed at Israeli behest.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports North Korea was hit with more sanctions on Friday, designed to impede access to the U.S. financial system in the wake of a cyber attack on Sony Pictures Entertainment, which the Obama administration has said was supported by the reclusive country. The U.S. government named three entities, including North Korea's military intelligence agency, and sanctioned 10 people with links to weapon sales and proliferation. Financial sanctions have allegedly been effective in bringing pressure on Iran and Russia, but they have had limited impact on North Korea, which has been sanctioned by the United States for more than 50 years. Joel Witt of 38 North, part of the U.S. Korea Institute at Johns Hopkins University in Washington, said, "It's not as if they travel a lot abroad to Western Europe or the United States. They don't have billions of dollars in Western banks." Pyongyang has denied involvement in the cyber attack. Washington said there was no evidence that any of the three entities or the individuals were linked to it. Treasury Secretary Jacob Lew said in a statement that Washington had a commitment to hold North Korea accountable for its destructive and destabilizing conduct. Lew said that even as a probe by the FBI continued, "These steps underscore that we will employ a broad set of tools to defend U.S. businesses and citizens and to respond to attempts to undermine our values or threaten the national security of the United States." The cyber attack that crippled Sony's network occurred as the company was preparing to release the film The Interview, a comedy centered on plans to assassinate North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un.
In the spirit of Motorhome Diaries and Liberty on Tour, I intend to take the message of peace, love, and liberty on the road. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit tour.fppradio.com. That's tour.fppradio.com.
UPI reports over 5,000 coins dating to the 11th century were found by metal-detecting amateurs in Britain. The hoard of coins was buried within a lead bucket, 2 feet below a field, about 42 miles west of London. Paul Coleman, a member of the Weekend Wanderers Detecting Club, whose membership walks open fields with handheld metal detectors in search of buried metal items, found the trove, 5,221 coins featuring the images of Ethelred the Unready and King Canute, who ruled England in the 9th century. A club spokesman said, "Without a doubt, this is the best find ever made in the Weekend Wanderers Detecting Club's 25-year history." Club member Peter Welch, who was present when the discovery was made, told BBC, "There was general silence and a sharp intake of breath of the people watching. This is something you dream of witnessing, let alone digging up. They look almost uncirculated, like they were straight from a mint." He added the mint where the coins were made was about a day's travel away by foot. The coins were taken to the British Museum of London for examination, and an investigation has begun to learn if they qualify under Britain's Treasure Act as items of historical importance whose proceeds from sale to a museum would be split between the finder and the landowner. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A heroic broken sewage pipe floods Congress with waste. Johnson & Johnson introduces new leave-in Q-tips. This Thursday, local youth Andrew Robillard told reporters he had no idea why he couldn't wear his Iron Man costume to his grandfather's funeral. Robillard, whose grandfather passed away this week after complications from a stroke, vented his frustration to reporters and noted that his grandpa, quote, probably wouldn't even care if he dressed like Iron Man at the funeral.
Iron Man is awesome. I want to wear my Iron Man suit. I am Iron Man.
And in tech news, a news website refers to its users' ceaseless exchange of racial slurs as a discussion. In other news, Guinness World Records promotes the man who can lift 27 pounds with his tongue to editor-in-chief. Thursday's cry is moved up to Wednesday due to a scheduling conflict, and a family watches in silence as dad checks out the waitress.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We are inviting you here. You can dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you may dial in again toll-free and also join us on our Skype. The Skype username is lrn.fm. With you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And Daryl.
And we're going to go right back into your phone calls and thoughts. But just to bring you up to speed in case you are just now tuning into the show, we do have a Gallup survey asking Americans what is the most important problem in the country today. The top answer this year was the number two answer the previous year and the number three answer in 2012. The top answer this year is government. We'll dig in further to that.
And it should be noted that the top answer came in at 18%.
That's correct.
And it's the first time since, I believe it was 2001, that nothing received over 20%.
Hmm. So we'll get into, we can dig into some more of the details here, but if you want to comment, you're welcome to do so, and you can also bring up anything you want. Plus, maybe you'd like to tell us what you think the biggest problem in the United States is, or anywhere in the world for that matter. This is an international show. We've got listeners all around the globe. Feel free to join the conversation as we go. Let's go to Nathan. He's listening in Indianapolis to WIBC. Hello, Nathan.
Hey.
You were actually on in the last hour, but you didn't have a whole lot of chance to really express yourself, so go ahead.
Yeah, I was saying how, you know, I think about the third parties and often, you know, think kind of, what's the use? And, you know, we vote, if we vote for them, will it make it, you know, 13% instead of 12 or something like that? You know, why wouldn't they run along with and against the Republicans in the primaries? To be able to get into the national stage and make a difference rather than running against them.
Well, there are very good reasons for running as a third-party candidate, and I hate the term third-party candidate because you know there shouldn't be this thought that you should only have two choices when it comes to politicians or when it comes to elected offices. I would love there to be, you know, like 7 or 8 or even 100, you know, parties that are actually ballot qualified. And the reason that it makes a difference is if you go back through history and you look at some of the dominant alternative parties, you will see that they have actually wound up having influence over the major parties as far as changing their platform.
From the outside. Not from the inside.
Because they shift the debate and they're able to bring in alternative ideas that people would not otherwise hear in the general election.
Also,
and he asked the question, why not just run in the major party primary? And the reason is not as many people pay attention to the major party primary for offices such as attorney general or, you know, like judicial whatever it is.
Well, also keep in mind this, Daryl, and I'm sure you'll agree with me on this as a longtime libertarian, that libertarians aren't necessarily Republicans. I mean, the presumption...
Right, or Democrats.
Right, the presumption in Nathan's question was, well, why don't they just run within the Republican Party? Well, that presumes libertarians have more they can identify with the Republicans than they can with Democrats, and neither one is necessarily true.
Right.
You got something you got to take care of there, Nathan?
No, he's good.
Okay, that's good. So, but my point being that while there are some libertarians who used to be Republicans, there are also libertarians who used to be Democrats as well, and there are also libertarians who used to be neither of those things.
Right.
And you know, like libertarians who don't have an appreciation for either the Republican or Democratic Party have no desire to try to change those two parties.
Right.
They would rather have a political party that from the outset agrees with their particular viewpoint rather than having this crazy conflict inside the Republicans or Democrats trying to mold an existing political institution into something that they want it to be. Does that make sense?
And I guess my reference to the primaries was more focused on the presidential race and maybe, you know, the other Senate races or something, but mainly the presidents, that they would be able to win out in the Republican Party and be in that, that general
But why
election,
would they win in the Republican the Party? The Republicans don't love liberty any more than Democrats do.
Yeah. And I mean, to bring that out in the not liberal, but the conservative arena and get the voters to, you know, go for them instead of, like I said, some
But libertarians aren't conservative.
Right. That's what I was trying to combat when I told you about how libertarians are not necessarily Republicans. There are some who are, who were Republicans, but others were Democrats. Some were socialists. Some were apolitical. Some were not connected to any political party at any point. The people who understand, the people in the Libertarian Party, at least they should be principled people who understand the ideas of liberty. And you don't find many of those people within the Republican or Democratic parties. What makes you think that the libertarian ideas would fly further in the Republican Party than anywhere else?
Well, not as much to the party itself, but to the voters.
How many Republican voters want to see an end to the war on drugs?
I don't know. That's some of the topics I don't realize, I guess.
Yeah. So, I mean, look, it's not to say that there aren't things within the Republican Party where they might like libertarians. Like, libertarians don't like taxes, for instance, and a lot of the Republican little guys don't like taxes, but the Republican politicians seem to have no problem with them whatsoever. And to some extent, this has already been tried, right, Nathan? So, like, Ron Paul, are you familiar with his campaigns in the year 2008 and 2012?
Yeah,
Ron Paul tried that, and they had these Ron Paul guys going to the Republican conventions and trying to use the system, use the rules of the system to get Ron Paul elected. And what ended up happening was they turned off their microphones, kicked them out of the events, changed the rules on the spot, made up their own rules, just completely violated the rules. They did everything they could do to try to keep the advocates of freedom who'd showed up there from even speaking to the Republican convention. So it's not to say that it hasn't been tried or that it couldn't be tried again in the future. And one thing's for sure about libertarians is you can't get them all on the same page. So even though there are some of them who would do what you're suggesting, there are many of them who, like Daryl and I, have no interest in, you know, joining up with the Republicans and spending our times there. But I thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Daryl, would there be anything that could make you want to join the Republicans or the Democrats?
No.
All right, there you go. Let's go to, I think we have Clayton. He is in Arkansas. Wait, Alaska? Clayton, where are you? Alaska?
I'm from Arkansas.
Arkansas, okay. All right, they got the initials wrong here. Go ahead, Clayton.
Sure. I mean, it sort of building on what the previous caller was saying, you know, we have a problem in terms of our electoral system in making room for third-party candidates, because currently, especially in legislative elections, you know, you can win with 35% of the vote. You can win with 25. You can win with any percentage of the vote as long as you have the highest percentage, or in Louisiana, have the highest two percentages. Mm-hmm. So until we really get past this plurality system of election, or at least past this first past the post system of election, and have proportional elections for our legislatures. So if 10% of the people vote libertarian, 10% of the legislature is libertarian, we're not going to see third parties really make a big entry into the legislative elections. And you know, and on executive elections, you know, something like the alternative vote system that is being proposed in Great Britain would really help third parties, having a preferential voting system, for example.
Where you rank the candidates.
Exactly, where you're ranking the candidates. And so people might be willing to put a first-choice candidate as a libertarian, knowing that that they have a backup to vote.
That would help eliminate the wasted vote syndrome.
And one thing that really helps the people in Canada and the UK is those two countries have fair ballot access, meaning that all parties and all candidates have the same requirement for getting on the ballot.
Yeah, that's not
the case. In the U.S., for the most part, that is not the case.
Yeah, and another part of that is, of course, in Great Britain, is that they have regionally popular parties. So, that, you know, for example, the SNP gives Labour a really hard, tough run for its money up in Scotland and so forth. I come from a state in Arkansas. We have a conservative party, the Republicans. We have another conservative party, the Democrats, and we have the far left Green Party. And really, the Green Party is one of the most, in Arkansas, is one of the most viable third parties anywhere.
Clayton, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I like the idea of proportional representation. Seems like an improvement.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, December 12th, 2014, gold opened at $1,216.60. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,261.34, $630.67 for a half ounce, or $315.33 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,261.34, $630.67, and $315.33.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Yeah. This is Free Talk Live, and you are invited here to take control of the airwaves at 855-450-FREE. It's the live Saturday edition of the program. Still plenty of time for you with your calls and thoughts here. Maybe you want to share with us what you think the biggest problem in the country is. And if you're not in the United States, tell us what the biggest problem is wherever you happen to be. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Join us on Skype as well at Skype username lrn.fm. Coming up on March 28th and 29th, that will be here before you know it, at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin, Texas. It's the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. Speakers, exhibitions, a great opportunity to do some networking, and they'll be hosting the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. At the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference, you'll find out what Bitcoin means to everyone and where the technology can go beyond just being a currency. If you want a glimpse into the future, you'll want to be in Austin, Texas. March 28th and 29th, go to TexasBitcoinConference.com. Get your tickets there. They're $150, which is already a good price for a weekend-long conference, but you'll save $25 off of that price if you use code FTL. FTL, like Free Talk Live, knocks $25 off the price, and another $25 of the ticket price will go and be donated to Sean's Outpost, which is a great Bitcoin-based homeless charity in North Florida, or I guess the panhandle of Florida?
The Pensacola area.
Pensacola, wherever the hell that is. TexasBitcoinConference.com. I know MK Lords lives in Pensacola.
It's on the panhandle.
Right. TexasBitcoinConference.com. Go there, grab your tickets, use code FTL to get the $25 off. As we go to your calls and thoughts, Lee is listening in Indiana to WIBC in Indianapolis. Hey, Lee. Do we have Lee in Indy? Lee in Indy?
Hi, I'm here.
Yes, we have you now. Hello. Go ahead, sir.
Hey, I think one of the bigger problems in the country is the contortion or the squashing of freedom of speech.
Mm.
If I want to say Christ is Lord, or I want to say there is no other God but Allah, or if I want to say homosexuality is wrong or it's right, if I want to say people should own guns or people shouldn't have the right to own guns, I can say those things, and I should be able to say those things with confidence, and as long as it's in a peaceful way, then I should be able to do it.
I agree.
Men and women have died for that right, but in certain settings, people can't talk about those things, especially in our educational venues. I can't believe that on a college campus, or many college campuses, I have to be standing in a certain geolocation in order to talk about those things. That's just dead wrong.
Yeah, I share your concerns there as someone who's actually done outreach on a college campus, and Daryl, you were there with me.
And been banned from the college campus.
Well, and arguably
that's
illegally
insane.
Banned. Yeah, and they ended up overturning the ban after our attorney sent a threatening letter to them. But nonetheless, that hasn't stopped them from continuing to threaten others who have attempted to do outreach on college campuses, like our very own Derek J. Freeman was one of the more recent ones who was threatened.
On Election Day.
Yeah, that's right. And so, yeah, I absolutely share your concerns. And it seems like it's hard for the average person to really do anything about it because, you know, the average person doesn't really know their rights. And if some college security bureaucrat comes up to you and says, hey, you got to stop handing these flyers out or you got to stop talking to the students, the average person is going to say, oh, I'm sorry. And they're going to turn around and walk away. And then they're going to essentially allow their freedom of speech to be trampled on. You have to basically stand up for the freedoms that you have in order to retain them. Otherwise, there are all kinds of government guys who will take away your freedoms from you, usually with your own voluntary assent. Lee, anything else you want to share?
No, thank you.
Thanks for the call. I appreciate hearing from you. So, yeah, the solution, of course, is not some sort of political solution, not to contact the politicians, but to keep speaking out, to go and challenge. But it can be scary when you get arrested for it.
Luckily, yeah. FIRE, which is the Foundation for Individual Rights in Education, they're actually challenging these policies in a lot of places.
True, but you have to be a student for FIRE to be interested in your case,
you
unfortunately.
Do.
So the average person who is not going to school at the school but yet still wants to go there for an outreach purpose or something, they don't have anybody that can back them up unless the ACLU is willing to take the case,
right,
or some other organization in that way. And sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. So you never really know, you know, in advance. If you're on a college campus and you're trying to get the word out about something and then somebody's trying to oppress your rights, you never know if you stand up for yourself and then ultimately
will
get arrested.
Will anybody back you?
Right. You can't guarantee that any lawyer or attorney is going to take interest in the case, work it pro bono, or you know, or on contingency, I guess. And so there are risks involved in this. And it, while it would be nice if we lived in a world where rights were just respected and freedom of speech was actually a real thing, we don't live in that world, and the only way to get closer to that world is to constantly push the envelope and push the boundaries of free speech, and that sometimes will get you thrown in a jail cell.
Yes.
So, unfortunately, and I've said this before, that the path to liberty sometimes leads through a jail cell.
Yeah.
I wish it didn't have to be that way, but it seems like it does.
2014, I think, is the first year in several that you were not actually inside a jail cell.
They did keep me in a containment cell for a short moment when I was arrested by the state police in April.
Okay.
I mean, it technically wasn't jail because I wasn't in the county jail, but when I did get booked by the state police, they did put me into a cell. They have a cell at the state police barracks. They put me in that cell, and I agreed that I, you know, I wasn't going to jump anybody or whatever.
Right.
So
you were there for what, like 2 hours?
I wasn't in the cell for that long. I was maybe there being processed for an hour or so, or an hour and a half or something like that. But yeah, they let me out basically. I agreed to be a good boy,
yeah,
and they let me out of the cell. So it was a fairly limited amount of time. Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. Daryl, let's dig in a little further here. The study, the poll by Gallup, as is cited over at Reason.com, says that the average American, in this poll at least, seems to consider government to be the most important problem in the United States. I don't know if the average is the right word to use, but Americans generally, 18% of them, 17%? Which one was it? 18%?
18%.
18% of Americans said government was the most important problem facing the United States. Following up government as other problems in 2014 included the economy at 17%, unemployment.
That's economy in general.
Okay.
So they actually have it broken down of everything that's related to the economy.
Okay, so housing
actually,
prices or something?
Right, that actually averages out to about 43%, but people that just gave the single one word economy, that is what is 17%.
So wait, are you saying, okay, so when,
so if somebody says the recession, then that is separate from economy,
okay,
in this particular answer. But if you dig deeper, they have economic issues and non-economic issues, and what they have listed as the economic issues averages about 43% throughout the year.
So does that mean that the economy should be a larger number than 17%? Because they did factor in multiple answers into the government answer, right?
They did, but on this... because it's, you know, economy in general.
Mm-hmm.
So just somebody giving that one word, they're calculating that different than if somebody said recession or taxes, right, or Social Security.
But if somebody said Congress, that would have counted as government.
Right.
That. Okay, so we'll come back with more here. And you've actually pulled up the survey itself and did,
yes,
some digging. You know, I'm sure you have things you want to highlight for us. We'll get into that. Your call's welcome at 855-450-FREE. More coming up on Free Talk Live.
I lost 18 pounds in just 4 days. Hi, I'm James Zetta. If you're like me, you've already tried and failed at many diet and weight loss plans. The 18 and 4 weight loss plan requires no exercising, no diet pills or additives, no laxatives, no meal replacements, and no diet drinks. The 18 and 4 program is crystal clear with a day-to-day, step-by-step, and meal-to-meal guide. If you're not satisfied with your results, I will give you my 30-day full money-back guarantee. Go to 18and4.com. That's the number 18, I-N, the number 4.com.
Hi. Hi, this is Larry Smith. Sometimes bad things happen to good people, like when the jeweler ruined my ring and wouldn't do anything about it. But when my Legal Shield attorney called him and told him what my rights were, I received a check for over $2,100. Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. Again, 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
In a move that puzzled patrons of the global fast food chain, McDonald's launched an extensive ad campaign this week entitled, "And Yet Is Not Beef Itself an Expression of Wanton Lust?" to air at prime time on several networks. The lengthy advertisement, which makes scant reference to any products or promotions, posits to viewers that perhaps beef is merely a symbolic expression of lust in its most wanton and depraved form.
When we call for beef, what are we really asking for? Is it the caress of a gentle lover? Or the blade of an executioner? The rage of steel on bone. Would you yourself deny beef? Would beef deny itself of you?
In other news, a spaced-out flower child is grooving on a doobie wave. A new study reveals nothing Pfizer's lawyers can't take care of, and the parents of an adorable child on a TV show are most likely insane. Thus ends nature's majestic cycle of weekly news reviews, only to gracefully begin itself anew in exactly 1 week's time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Dial in toll-free. Take control of the airwaves on this live Saturday edition of the program. With you tonight, you've got Ian.
And Daryl.
Join us online over at freetalklive.com and enjoy the features there. If you like the show and you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, then one of the things you could do is share Free Talk Live. If you've got a favorite episode from this week, just copy the archive link and drop it in your favorite social bookmarking website, maybe Twitter or Facebook or wherever it is you spend time online. Anything you can do to help spread Free Talk Live, we sure do appreciate. And we're going to continue with your calls and thoughts. Also, more on this Gallup survey finding that Americans are sick and tired of government. They are saying that government is the most important problem in the country today. We will tell you more about that study here in a moment, because maybe they aren't sick of government. Maybe some of them think government needs to be bigger. So I don't know what the answer, government being the problem, means, but that's the question was, what is the most important problem in the country today? And government ranked in at 18% as the top-ranked issue.
And it was actually dissatisfaction with government, Congress, politicians. And I'm guessing they mean dissatisfaction with Congress, dissatisfaction right. with politicians.
That's not new, though, right?
Like poor leadership. Corruption and abuse of power are all lumped together.
As government. So that says that there's definitely frustration. I don't think that would... So it sounds like the numbers do include people who might think government should just be different, right?
Right.
Like
these aren't They're necessarily, not doing enough!
Yeah. So let's go to James in Arizona via Skype. James, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Daryl. Hello?
Yes, if only the Weimar Republic had had a winner-take-all election system like the United States of America does, the fascist Nazi party would have never happened. And I can't think of one parliamentary system on planet Earth that has existed in your lifetime, Ian, that has a smaller government than the United States of America. In fact, they all have much bigger national governments. So I hope that we never have a constitutional amendment to have a proportional voting system.
Thanks for the call tonight, James. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What do you think, Daryl? I mean, would parliamentary systems, proportional representation, would that mean that the U.S. would become a larger government?
I don't think that you could necessarily say that it would become larger. You can't necessarily say that it would become smaller. Mm-hmm. But what you can say is that more diverse ideas would be represented within the government body.
I don't see how that would be a bad thing at all. And, I mean, especially because right now libertarians don't have a voice whatsoever
right. In
government, except in New Hampshire, where they're actually winning as Republicans and Democrats. But in most places—
And a lot of Republicans and Democrats are, you know, getting butthurt because, well, these people are lying to the voters
yeah. And
saying they're Republicans and Democrats. But back in the 90s, when the Republicans and Democrats made the ballot access more difficult, the argument was— Well, the libertarians that we just removed from the ballot, they can just run as Republicans or Democrats.
Sure.
So, you know, they're totally changing their tune 20 years later.
So, Daryl, the Reason article here gave us the basic info. You actually pulled up details on this Gallup survey. What did you want to share from that?
So they've been doing this survey for about 50 years,
okay. Which
is fairly interesting. And I've pulled up the July and the December actual full report that they have so that I could look at all of the—
Right, they're doing a monthly.
Right, they do this monthly. And race relations actually was the highest for December, where it wound up being,
Eric Garner controversy.
Well, no, the Eric Garner thing started in July.
Yeah.
But it really sort of ramped up. Race relations hit 13% last month. And they have economic issues and non-economic issues. So economic issues totaled about 43% on average. Mm-hmm. So what they have listed under that is economy in general. And I'm thinking that the way they have this is if somebody just gave the one-word answer, economy. Second under that list is unemployment and jobs.
Mm-hmm.
The federal budget or federal debt. And then the gap between rich and poor. A lack of money. Taxes. And
what percentage with a lack of money?
Lack of money seems to be consistently about 1%.
Okay.
The wow. Taxes seems to be consistently about 1%. Corporate corruption seems to be about 1%. And then below that, it's things that showed up sporadically throughout the year at 1%
or less.
You know, less than 1% would be wage issues, fuel and oil prices, inflation, foreign trade, and recession.
Before.
Not listed as an economic issue is welfare that, again, shows up consistently about 1%.
You know, it's interesting that only 1% would say taxes are the biggest problem facing the U.S. Does that suggest that people are fine with taxes the way they are? They don't like government, but they're okay with taxes? It's hard to really read anything
right, because
this.
You only get to give one answer.
Right.
They're not saying, what are the top five?
Yeah, that's true.
And then you list off five problems.
Mm-hmm.
They're saying, what is the one problem that is the biggest?
And they're saying government is the biggest problem. Yeah, actually, according to the Reason story here, they say that these findings are hardly coming out of the blue. Pew, another research group, finds the public trust in the government at 24%. is near historic lows. So that's a good indicator, right? People don't trust the government.
I don't know if that's necessarily a good indicator or not, because people could not trust the government because they think, well, they should be doing more and spending more on this and that and the other thing. So, you know, I don't necessarily think that there's a correlation between somebody not trusting the government and somebody being pro-liberty.
I'm not saying that means they're pro-liberty, but I don't think that not trusting the government necessarily means that you want the government to do something else. It could just mean that the government has just withered away through erosion over time, people's trust.
I would need to see more information about that specific survey.
Right.
What were the other questions that were asked? And then maybe I could correlate some kind of idea. And there was somebody that mentioned this a couple days ago. There was a group of us eating at one of the local buffets after James Cleveland had his court hearing, and they mentioned this survey, and they were trying to make the correlation that, you know, people are lacking trust in the government, so therefore the ideas of liberty are, you know, spreading to at least 24%, and I don't think that you can necessarily make that argument.
I don't think you can. I don't think that you can make any sort of correlation that any amount of Americans cares about freedom out of any of these statistics.
Right.
They're just interesting to look at. They're interesting to talk about. Interesting indicators that people are at the very least frustrated. They're at the very least upset with the status quo. And does that mean that they would all of a sudden be happy if a Republican got into office? I doubt it. Because these numbers have been pretty piss poor for a long time.
Right, and I've seen surveys that showed, you know, upwards of 63% of Americans say that the federal government does not have the consent of the governed. There are other surveys that, you know, after the swing in the Senate going from Democratic control to Republican control, the question was asked, was this a vote of support for the Republicans or a vote in opposition to the Democrats? And consistently, going back for a decade, it's a rejection of the party that was in power by like 60% instead of, you know, support of this other party. And
so lesser of two evils.
Right. The lesser of two evils. 60% of Americans consistently say that they're open to the idea of voting for a third party or an independent candidate.
But they're scared to do it.
But they're scared to do it.
Because of the wasted vote syndrome.
Because of the wasted vote syndrome. And if you look through history, whenever there has been a strong alternative candidate, there has always been backlash in ballot access.
As far as they make it harder to get on the ballot. More coming up here in moments. Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write "worms" in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Chuck Woolery here. You know, I've talked before about Australian Dream, the effective arthritis pain relief cream that doesn't burn, isn't greasy, and has no odor. Now there's new Australian Dream back pain cream with all those great benefits. But this penetrating formula can help relieve your simple back pain. And it's backed by an empty jar guarantee. If you're not satisfied, you can send back the empty jar for a full refund. But I don't think you will, because Australian Dream really works. Don't let back pain ruin your day. Get Australian Dream back pain cream at Walgreens.
Alex Jones here. For the last 2 years, I've been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to design a nutraceutical formulation that has truly life-changing health benefits. So many other formulations out there contain toxic ingredients, synthetic additives, and even GMOs. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. Now is the time to secure ancient defense for you and your family. Visit InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139. That's InfoWarsLife.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial toll-free and bring up anything that's on your mind at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Moments remain here on this live Saturday edition, but no worries. We do a Sunday show. If you don't get your call in tonight or you don't have time to call tonight, no, you can just call us tomorrow from 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time when I believe Adamo Freeman will be co-hosting with me from copblock.org. So we'll do that then, but in the meantime, we go to you with your calls and thoughts. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. We've got Al listening in Maine. Al, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Daryl.
Difficulty in America is that we have two essentially Marxist parties, the Republican and the Democrat Party. They're based on Marxist ideology. That's the belief that the most important thing in the life of man is money. And Republicans say they want to increase the wealth. And Democrats say we want to spread the wealth around. But the answer, nonetheless, is wealth. And it's not so with man. So essentially what they've created, with the talk of freedom and equality and everything, they've created essentially a lawless society, the most lawless society in the history of the world.
How would you say that the United States is the most lawless society in the world when there are more volumes of laws than could be read in, I've heard, four lifetimes?
Well, that's precisely the reason, because when you don't have the law inside, don't have God's law written on your heart, you need it on the outside to coerce people. When you take away the teaching that man is simply an animal, that's what's taught in our schools and universities, you're left with the law of the jungle that might makes right. And that's the reason why you have the increasing police presence. Not because the police are evil, because there's more criminality. And
actually, there's no evidence for that. The country's gotten more peaceful over time, but the police have become more violent, but the actual violent crime is down.
Well, if you've lived in any major urban area, you know exactly how peaceful it is. It's so peaceful that if you walk down certain streets at night, then we cannot expect to come back out alive.
Now, you think that has to do with the lack of biblical teachings?
Man has been reduced to the law of the jungle. I think the worst aspect, and it's the most pervasive aspect of American society, is rock and roll. The syncopated music. You laugh because it's embarrassed laughter.
No, it's not embarrassed.
It's a confession.
It's because you're so funny.
It's true. It's music.
Rock and roll music is out of favor, dude. Pop music, rap music, this is more popular than rock and roll music. You sound like you're calling from the 1970s.
Hip-hop. No, I'm calling from the future. What America will be once America's healed and the right people take charge.
Now, I see. So the right people. So who are the right people? Because you did open your call by saying the Republicans and the Democrats were bad news, that they were Marxist. Now, I'm certainly no fan of the Republicans or Democrats, and there's an argument to be made that they both support socialism. But, you know, what would you like to see happen, Al? Sounds like you'd want a theocracy.
I would like to see America healed. And part of that is not a revolution, but a restoration in which the past becomes the future. We preserve the good things of the past, and we eliminate the evil of the present. Chief among them being the music, because the music...
So, like, let me see if I could clarify then. So, I'm just trying to understand where you're coming from. So, you would see a future in which, like on television, the husband and wife sleep in separate beds again. But yet, at the same time, we also have hoverboards?
Oh, certainly. Certainly.
So, that's your future then, Al, right? So, like, no sex, got to keep people away from sex, and no drugs, right?
We would eliminate... we would outlaw the teachings of Freud, Sigmund Freud.
What about gambling?
Outlaw the teachings of Marx.
Outlawing. So you'd burn some books then, is what you're saying?
No, it wouldn't be necessary to burn the books.
Well, wait a minute. How do you outlaw something? How do you outlaw this information but yet still allow the books around?
Well, they could no longer be taught because... there would be a law where you cannot teach lies and errors, and we know Sigmund Freud was a liar.
So we
know that now. We know Marx was a liar.
Well, I don't know.
But would you physically prevent someone, or you probably would say that you would not physically prevent them? Would you use the police to physically prevent someone from picking up a book written by Sigmund Freud?
No, they prevent it from being. It could be published in limited numbers, a kind of museum of falsehood and error.
A limited number. So if I wanted to, Daryl, you're a publisher by trade over at fpp.cc, and you take books that have expired copyright. I presume Marx would probably have an expired copyright at this point. Not that you would do this because you don't agree with Marx, but if you wanted to, given that, let's say, Al gets his druthers and it's Al's world now, and...
I would... do it just because somebody said you can't do this.
Just because you can't do it. So Daryl's now saying he's going to publish the works of Marx and Freud in your world, Al. So what would you do to Daryl? What would you like to see happen?
Well, they have been published. What would we do to him?
Yeah.
Well, we would seize his property.
So you would steal from me because I want to publish a book. Okay.
What property would you steal from him? His whole publishing company?
Printing press.
The whole press. Okay.
Yes, and we put it to good use.
No, your interpretation of what's a good use. Now, it's not good to steal things now, is it, Al? I thought you were a Christian. You're not a Christian, are you?
It's a consensus.
But you're not a Christian, though, right?
Yes, I am.
You are. Wait a minute. What about don't steal? Don't you understand? I mean, that's a pretty clear commandment, right?
It's not.
It's not stealing when we do it. Right.
If you're using a machine for illicit purpose, then that can be confiscated.
Oh, it's not stealing. It's confiscation. So when you and your goons in the police department take things from people that aren't theirs, like Daryl's printing press, that's not stealing. You're just confiscating it.
Now, confiscation and stealing is different. No, it's not.
One's a euphemism.
One is done under the guise of law.
Yeah.
And the other is not, but both of them are depriving someone of their property.
Right. So let's say, Daryl, you've come into Daryl's printing press area, and Daryl's home at the time. We're at the shop or wherever it is the printing press is, and Daryl's there, and he says, "No, sir, you are not coming to take my printing press," and he ties himself to it with handcuffs. What will you do then?
Well, this is all hypothetical, and there have been cases like this in the in the past, but the machine, because it's an instrument, a tool which is used to harm mankind by propagating errors, the lies of Karl Marx, the lies of Sigmund Freud, it would be confiscated and put to good use.
But Daryl's a big man. Daryl, I don't know what you weigh, but it's probably at least 270 pounds.
Somewhere in that neighborhood.
You're a big guy, and it would make it even more difficult for you to take his printing press if Daryl had handcuffed himself to it. So what are you going to do about that?
Argument, again, though, you're going back to the...
Sir, I'm asking you a direct question. What if not only Daryl handcuffed himself to it, but all of his employees... handcuff themselves to it.
I don't want to personalize it.
This is personal. You're talking about taking people's property.
No, it's not.
Every time you confiscate or steal something from someone, it's personal. What are you going to do? He's handcuffed himself to it.
The state does have a right to confiscate those instruments or those.
Just come right out. Tell us what you'll do, Al. Will you bust his head open? Will your cops set the place on fire? What are you going to do about it?
Well, now you sound simply, you're quite enraged by this.
Yeah, that's right, because I get pretty upset when people come around and act like thugs and steal things and take things that aren't theirs. I get upset about that.
You see, this is your
society. And you know what? And then they try to pretend like they're not going to use violence in order to get their way, Al. You're trying to paper over the violence that you're very willing to utilize to crush Daryl's rights. Shame on you.
And then they wind up doing things to where instead of he doesn't want to make it personal, but it is personal. They want to use terms like insurgent or outlaw because, you know, who wants to stand up for the rights of an outlaw?
You have no rights.
Why do I have no rights?
Because you're printing illicit materials, Daryl. The works of Marx.
Do you have no right to tell me what I can or can't do that causes no unjust harm to another human being?
Al, I gotta say, I love your calls because you are one of the craziest utopian callers that we have on this show, and I hope you'll continue to call. Go ahead with your final message for us. Remember what?
Yours is a failed society.
This isn't my society. I'm a member of the Shire Society. I have left the government society and joined my own with Daryl and others. Daryl, you Shire Society?
Yes.
Daryl and others who have signed the document at ShireSociety.com. Thank you, Al. Anybody listening to the show can join a peaceful society of people who will respect the rights of others. ShireSociety.com. Go there. Check out the declaration. If you care about freedom, I think you'll like it. Not Al. He'd hate it.
Hey guys, Mark Claire here, LionsOfLiberty.com, where we strive to advance the ideas of liberty daily. We bring you The Morning Roar! That's right, every Monday to Friday, we'll have a brand new edition of The Morning Roar, where we provide a roundup of some news stories that you may not find in the mainstream media, or even in your typical social media news feed. We find stories that relate to the ideas of liberty and provide you with our liberty perspective on them. Every Monday, we have our longest-running feature, Mondays with Murray, named after the great libertarian Murray Rothbard, where we'll examine an article or an excerpt from his works and help convey his view, along with our little spin as well. We wrap it all up every Friday with Felony Friday, where our own John Odermatt goes out and takes a look at some sort of felony. There's felonies committed every day, you know, whether it's a felony committed by the police, a politician, or even an average citizen. You can find all of this and so much more over at LionsOfLiberty.com, advancing the ideas of liberty daily.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinnertime conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today. The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, January 3rd, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.78 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,189 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $301. Antiwar.com reports the State Department has warned it intends to review all aid provided to the Palestinian Authority in the wake of their bid to join the International Criminal Court, saying the bid would have implications. Congress has already mandated that all aid to the Palestinians be cut off if they attempt to file a single claim against the Israeli occupation, though clearly the U.S. often ignores its own law with respect to aid provisions at any rate. The U.S. has made it clear they oppose ICC membership for the Palestinians, though there does not seem to be any particular reason for the ICC to deny their membership. The Palestinian Authority decided to pursue the bid after their failed attempt to pass a resolution calling for an end to the Israeli occupation at the UN Security Council, which the U.S. vetoed at Israeli behest.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports North Korea was hit with more sanctions on Friday, designed to impede access to the U.S. financial system in the wake of a cyber attack on Sony Pictures Entertainment, which the Obama administration has said was supported by the reclusive country. The U.S. government named three entities, including North Korea's military intelligence agency, and sanctioned 10 people with links to weapon sales and proliferation. Financial sanctions have allegedly been effective in bringing pressure on Iran and Russia, but they have had limited impact on North Korea, which has been sanctioned by the United States for more than 50 years. Joel Witt of 38 North, part of the U.S. Korea Institute at Johns Hopkins University in Washington, said, "It's not as if they travel a lot abroad to Western Europe or the United States. They don't have billions of dollars in Western banks." Pyongyang has denied involvement in the cyber attack. Washington said there was no evidence that any of the three entities or the individuals were linked to it. Treasury Secretary Jacob Lew said in a statement that Washington had a commitment to hold North Korea accountable for its destructive and destabilizing conduct. Lew said that even as a probe by the FBI continued, "These steps underscore that we will employ a broad set of tools to defend U.S. businesses and citizens and to respond to attempts to undermine our values or threaten the national security of the United States." The cyber attack that crippled Sony's network occurred as the company was preparing to release the film The Interview, a comedy centered on plans to assassinate North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un.
In the spirit of Motorhome Diaries and Liberty on Tour, I intend to take the message of peace, love, and liberty on the road. To find out more about the tour or to donate, visit tour.fppradio.com. That's tour.fppradio.com.
UPI reports over 5,000 coins dating to the 11th century were found by metal-detecting amateurs in Britain. The hoard of coins was buried within a lead bucket, 2 feet below a field, about 42 miles west of London.
Paul Coleman, a member of the Weekend Wanderers Detecting Club, whose membership walks open fields with handheld metal detectors in search of buried metal items, found the trove, 5,221 coins featuring the images of Ethelred the Unready and King Canute, who ruled England in the 9th century. A club spokesman said, without a doubt, this is the best find ever made in the Weekend Wanderers Detecting Club's 25-year history. Club member Peter Welch, who was present when the discovery was made, told BBC, there was general silence and a sharp intake of breath of the people watching. This is something you dream of witnessing, let alone digging up. They look almost uncirculated, like they were straight from a mint. He added the mint where the coins were made was about a day's travel away by foot. The coins were taken to the British Museum of London for examination, and an investigation has begun to learn if they qualify under Britain's Treasure Act as items of historical importance whose proceeds from sale to a museum would be split between the finder and the landowner. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Buying a burger might start taking a bite out of your wallet. Meat prices skyrocketed this week after the place that makes the meat revealed that the cow smashing machine is all beefed up.
This machine has beef way up in it. The basher, the meat collector, even a main meat hall, all of it. Lousy with beef.
The cow smashing machine is an integral part of the meat making process, taking whole big cows into one end, with all different meats falling out the other. Supermarket chains warn that unless we start smashing cows again soon, we could face a serious beef shortage. The beef industry is working hard to unclog the cow smasher, but says it could take several days or even weeks to scoop all the beef that's crammed up in there. Until it's fixed, meat-hungry Americans can take solace in the fact that the chicken grinder is working at full capacity, just completely tearing up all those chickens, and the pig machine is porking out hardcore. Up next, bluesmen find a rising trend of their babies done leaving on that there old devil train.
This is the Onion News Network. It's time for Off the Air Live. And here's your host, Cody O'Connor.
Hey, what's going on? It is Off the Air Live, Saturday edition of the show. And you hear us every Saturday from 10 to midnight on LRN.FM. It's going to be weird saying that now. Phone lines are now up, though. That's cool. New thing for the Portland studio. So you can now call us once again at 774-314-7067. Or you can Skype in at Off the Air Live if you want to. I got some things right off the bat that I need to get off from my chest. My chest is filled with anger that needs to be spread out over the interwebs into your brains. That is kind of a mean thing to do, right? Like, I'm sitting here, and I've got all these things I'm mad about, and I'm going, ooh, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to tell everybody about it so they're mad about it too. I don't want to be the only one. I got to make them mad. But I think everybody else is on the same page as I am on this. And this is what it is. You might even be surprised about this. I am tired of everybody talking about a certain person's butt. Which is really surprising coming from me. Because usually I'm going to be pro-butt. Pro-butt is possible. Most pro-butt person you've ever heard in talk radio. I love talking about butts. I really appreciate a nice butt. I appreciate a big butt too. But there's a certain person who is abusing her endowments, abusing her gifts. And frankly, I don't think this person is as great as everybody thinks she is. I think she's a little bit overrated. And I don't think I'm really going out on too many limbs by saying that. Talking about this Kim. You know her last name. I don't need to say it. I feel bad even bringing this fucking shit up. I really do. But it needs to happen for a specific reason. I'm not getting in on the gossip, okay? That's not what this is. What it is me sitting everybody down and saying, here's the deal. We're not going to let this keep going on, right? We're gonna put our foot down as people of this planet and say there are more important things than this person's behind. Now, I sort of get this weird idea. Call in if you think I'm wrong. But I get this idea that When you go on Twitter and you see what's a trending hashtag, or you go on Facebook and you see what's trending, I don't know if that's completely accurate. I think somebody spent enough money where they go, well, we're rich and what we're going to do. We're doing a viral marketing campaign, but here's the thing, is we're going to make it viral. Sort of like the CIA injecting Ebola or something ridiculous like that. That's what's going on with these things. And that's what pisses me off, because there was a time when something went viral because it just went viral. It was a video, it was something super cute, or a guy falling on his ball sack, and it was really funny. And now it's just these companies came in and they realized that viral marketing is the new in thing to do. And not only that, but it's way cheaper than spending money putting shit on TV. Because who's watching TV anymore? Old people. And they're not spending their social security checks on whatever magazine you think you're going to sell with some nude lady on the front of it. I'll tell you that much. That's going to go to the younger kids. You know, the ones who have working penises still. Those ones. And it's really gross that everybody fell for it and we're talking about it. So here's what I'm going to tell everybody. If you want this stuff to go away, stop participating in it. And I know you might immediately be saying, well, Cody, you're talking about it right now. You're such a hypocrite.